Okay, actually, and listener, in this the World Environment Day, we will be having an interview with our Minister for Environment and Forestry, Siti Nurbaya Bakar, and I believe that she is on the lines.
Yeah, thank you, Steve. Let me explain how do we deal with this environmental aspects, and in particular regarding the climate change agenda from platform of the conceptual policy as well as in the practice. And the government of Indonesia has actively involved in the international climate actions as one of countries that ratified the UN Framework Convention on Climate Change and the Kyoto Protocol. That the government of Indonesia has ratified the convention through law. First one is in 1994, and the recent one is in 2016. That is on Paris Agreement. Indonesia as well has national commitment towards low carbon and climate resilience development direction, with climate adaptation and mitigation as an integrative and cross-sectoral priority in the national development agenda. The commitment has been reflected in the submission of Indonesia's first national determined contribution, which we submit to the UNFCCC Secretariat. And in principle, the NDC is used as a reference for implementing climate change mitigation commitments, in which that Indonesia has set on the for 41% of the business as usual scenario by 2030, with the support of international cooperation and financial support. And for our own budget, we define for 29%. In practice, Indonesia has been having great efforts to reduce gas emission, as I can give you some examples. This is of course related to any activities that we have been doing in environment and forestry. Indonesia has successfully managed deforestation at the lowest level, that is 115,000 hectares in 2020. But beforehand, in the 2018 to 2019, was recorded of 450,000 hectares. And let's say in 2014 to 2015 was recorded for 1.1 million hectares. So that means we have been having successful for reduce the deforestation. The significant reduction is from forest fire incidents and deforestation leading to emission reduction. So the second one, we have policies under presidential decree for about 66 million hectares of primary forest and peatland that be protected and not allowed for exploitation. It is a protection primary forest and peatland started in 2013, and now we define permanently in 2019. Since 28 September, for 3 years later after September 2018, under presidential instruction, it is not allowed also to have new license or to give the areas for the new license from forest land for oil palm plantation. By September this year, going to be 3 years already, and we will do evaluate if it is necessary to expand it of the policy. The result saved for Indonesia effort has been admired as all of the policies and activities on Red Plus agenda, we call it. That is reducing deforestation and forest degradation, such as in primary forest, peatland, moratorium of the primary forest and peatland, and oil palm, managing adat community, we do social forestry, we do land rehabilitation, etc. We, Indonesia, now got result-based payment, we call it, as a kind of reward. It is promised and has been calculated and has been agreed from letter of intent of Norway for about 11.2 tons of CO2 for $56 million, as well as from World Bank, the agenda of Forest Carbon Partnership Facilities that is covering for 100 $10 million US dollar result-based payment, as well as for biocarbon fund for $60 million US dollar in the plan of DCS for 103 US dollar. This is an ongoing process. Moreover, the obvious activities and result in forest fire, if we remember the 2015 accident, we have area burn of about 2.6 million hectares with more than 900 million tons of CO2, and in 2019 as well, the area burn of about 1.6 million hectares and emission of about 600 million tons, but and now on 2020 last year, we have about 290,000 hectares area burn and emission about 40 million tons CO2. So the forest fire management is also the key factor for managing this emission reduction of CO2. During 2015 to 2021, we planted trees for about 1.4 million hectares, and this year we plant mangrove for 30,000 hectares, and we will cover up for 2024 for 630,000 hectares. So next, it is now in the ongoing plan. We will continue with some improvement agenda, such as the real actions at the sub-national level for Red Plus program in East Kalimantan and Jambi. We will continue to other provinces and subjects. Priority set on energy sector efforts, such as conversion to renewable energy and roadmap for phasing out coal. Priority set on marine sector for mitigation as well as adaptation, considering that finance and technology are very essential. And of course, we encourage private sector support, and we are preparing sovereign wealth fund and green investment bonds. And now it is in the final stage for the carbon price regulation and carbon taxes and economic of carbon, something like that. And focusing on green energy for green industry, that is in our plan of center for green energy for green industry in North Kalimantan, based on hydrogen technology, exploring technology of carbon capture and storage, carbon capture utilization storage, implementing renewables and BCCS, bioenergy, carbon capture and storage. Something like that, Raven. Okay. Thank you very much.
All right. I think as Indonesian, I expect that I only get one sentence or two, but actually there are a lot of commitment by our country, right, for the environment. That is so great. I think Indonesians should be proud about this. And Bu Siti, this year's theme of the World Environment Day is Recreate, Reimagine, and Restore. So in conjunction to this theme, what will Indonesia do?
Oh, thank you, Faith. Well, actually, since 2004, the Ministry of Environment and Forestry, and former time they call it only Ministry of Forestry, has launched an ecosystem restoration program involving about 33,000 villages around forest areas. The main target is the village community so that they can produce sufficient goods and services and then receive the benefits. Then the Ministry of Environment and Forestry is committed to restoring degraded mangrove ecosystem and has issued a national action program of land degradation mitigation. From 2020 to 2024, we'll undertake forest and land rehabilitation activities, focusing on construction of 60 dams, rehabilitation of 3,000 watersheds, 15 prioritized lakes and 1.1 million hectares of disaster-prone watershed. Based on current financing capacity, land rehabilitation targets for 2021 is about 220,000 hectares and will be increased to 230,000 hectares per year from 2022 to 2024. This includes mangrove rehabilitation, Then the current data shows that we will cover 637 hectares to rehabilitate mangrove up to 2024. And this year we will cover about 83,000 hectares. Rehabilitation efforts taken by Indonesian government include the rehabilitation of reservoirs, priority lake areas and river basins, and also the development of mangrove forests and urban forests, and the third one, the establishment of community nurseries. Efforts may also include the construction of dams and retaining bars, gully plug, and absorption wells. Overall, up to 2021, the government has succeeded in carrying out large-scale land restoration with a total area of not less than 4.69 million hectares, including peat and mangroves. The restoration activities that have been taken place include the development of mangrove forests and urban forests, the establishment of community nurseries, the construction of dams, and infiltration wells. In the future, various recommendations and innovation in restoration technology will continue to be disseminated to the public and policymakers, especially related to restoration of peat ecosystem, restoration of watershed, restoration of post-eruption volcanic ecosystem, restoration of degraded land, and restoration of ex-mining areas. One of our main concerns is the future is to continue to carry out restoration activities on degraded peat land. This is important taking into account that the livelihoods of the surrounding community are highly dependent on peat land. Then the three principles of peat restoration that will continue to be intensified are rewetting, revegetation, and revitalization of community livelihoods. Please let me also inform you regarding ecosystem restoration, also reflected in the concession management, that is a recovery management at the forest area, in which at the log over area to recover the natural vegetation in the sense of canopies as well as biodiversity. So this kind of things we have been doing a lot, Steve. Hopefully gonna be good and we can have better environment. Yes. Thank you, Pete.
Yes, hopefully we can have a very better environment so that, well, our future children will be living comfortably in our country. So, Bu Siti, for the last question for every people. So now down to the people, what can we do individually, as individual people, to support the ecosystem restoration?
Yeah, well, actually, in environment aspect, of course, we have to avoid the activities in which destroying landscape. So we will manage with the landscape system, landscape management, compared to, let's say, only timber management and those kind of things. In Indonesia, we have, as I mentioned before, we have more than 30,000 villages that we are dealing now with the social forestry. So individually, there is also responsibility for from the people to deal with this environment. We would rather to promote, let's say, something like for the community livelihood, which is friendly, environmental friendly, like ecotourism and those kind of things. Of course, for the urban community, we'll be dealing with agendas and working on, let's say, emission reduction and managing our waste. And also we do something that is supporting the river, that we will have, let's say, good quality of water in the river and those kind of things. And of course, we will manage and on the air quality that we can have a good air for the community. Something like that, please. Thank you.
Okay, Ibu Siti Nurbaya Bakar, thank you very much for joining us and sharing how Indonesia is doing for the environment for the World Environment Day. Thank you very much, Ibu Siti.
Thank you.
Have a good day.
Thank you. Yeah, the same to you too, Faye. Thank you very much and have a good day.
Have a good day, Bu. Terima kasih.